Meeting's order, please rise for a salute to our flag, followed by a moment of silence. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I'd like people to remain standing for a moment of silence for Pastor Healy of the Grace and Peace Church. He was big, not only with that church, but the Interfaith Hospitality Network, the Toms River Housing and Homeless Coalition, and he was a big advocate for Samaritan's Purse, which affected many lives here during Hurricane Sandy when they came to assist our residents and help rebuild their homes. Okay, thank you. Please be seated. Okay. This meeting is convened in accordance with the provisions of the Open Public Meetings Act of New Jersey. Let the official minutes reflect that adequate notice of this meeting has been provided by publishing a notice in the Asbury Park Press on Friday, January 8th, 2021, the Press of Atlantic City and the Star Ledger, and also forwarded to the Toms River Times, Toms River Patch, and WOBM News on network on Wednesday, January 6th, 2021, and thereafter posting same on the Town Hall bulletin board for such notices and filing same with the Township Clerk pursuant to a resolution adopted by the Township Council on Tuesday, January 5th, 2021. The meeting dates have also been posted on the Township webpage. Roll call, please.
Councilwoman Urich.
Here.
Councilman Kopp.
Here.
Councilman Letano.
Here.
Councilman Roderick.
Here.
Councilman Turnbach. Council Vice President Maruca.
Present.
Council President Gagan.
Here.
First item, minutes from March 9, 2021.
Approve the minutes.
Second.
Was that motion made by Councilman Kopp and seconded by Councilwoman Urich? Councilman Kopp.
Yes.
Councilwoman Urich.
Yes.
Councilman Letano.
Yes.
Councilman Roderick.
Yes.
Councilman Turnbach.
Yes.
Council Vice President Maruca.
Yes.
Council President Gagan.
Yes.
Tonight, we have two honoring resolutions or presentations, Stigma-Free Proclamation and the Education Day Proclamation.
Move the honoring resolutions and presentations.
Second.
Motion was made by Councilwoman Urich, seconded by Councilman Turnbach. Councilwoman Urich.
Yes.
Councilman Turnbach.
Yes.
Councilman Kopp.
Yes.
Councilman Letano.
Yes.
Councilman Roderick.
Yes.
Council Vice President Maruca.
Yes.
Council President Gagan.
Yes. Council, if you would, please join me.
My name is Jessica Alpert. I'm the Community Outreach Coordinator for RWJ Barnabas Behavioral Health Center here in Toms River with my colleague Claire Donnell, who is our lead for our Toms River Communities That Care, which is a coalition comprised of multiple partners local to the community to help keep our youth, you know, on the right track, substance-free, but also maintaining emotional and resiliency. I'm sure that we can all say, you know, with the pandemic, we all may know ourselves or someone close to us that has struggled with their mental health. We have come a long way with breaking stigma, but we still have a long way to go. And this resolution and this recognition by the council and by the community is really going to allow us to move forward on initiatives that will continue to break the stigma of mental health. So we really look forward to doing some initiatives and getting the community involved. And we just want to say thank you so much to everybody in the council for passing this resolution. And
thank
we do have
much.
Some things for you guys. So these are mental health resources, pamphlets, calendars, and Claire also has some stigma-free signs. So
well,
thank you
very,
very
much.
Much.
We'll leave that here. And we have...
Thank you so much. Yes, that would be great.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, yeah. That's perfect. And let's move this.
Look, you should be a repeater person. Thank you very much. On behalf of the mayor and council, a proclamation for everything you do for Education Day for the community. And if you'd like to give a few words of, you know, what exactly it is that you do.
Thank you. Take the mask off. Okay. Just very briefly, tonight and tomorrow marks the birthday of my teacher, the Grand Rabbi, the leader of the Chabad movement. And over the last 40 years, the president on either side of the aisle, Congress, and many states and cities and townships around the country mark his birthday as Education Day. And it represents one of his teachings that each and every single individual has a spark of God or a spark of goodness inside of them. And everybody has potential, and everybody has the ability to be good if we only can bring it out in them or in ourselves. And what we did is we referred to today as Education Day, which is a day that we can focus on uncovering the good that's within us, uncovering the good that's within the next person. We may disagree, we may have different approaches to life, but beneath that all, there is a spark of goodness. And the next generation of leaders are the children of today. And if we can educate them, and if we can give them this approach and this outlook on life, then what we can ultimately do is change the future to bring out the best and the most beautiful part of this world and make the world a better place. And make Tom's River, as good as it is, make it an even better place. Yes. So I wanted to say thank you to the council and to the mayor. And thank you, Mayor, and to the entire Township Council for this proclamation. And let's hope that at least in the next 24 hours, and hopefully that inspires us for beyond that time, we can do something in the area of educating ourselves and others, children, adults, to make this world a better place and make our beautiful township an even more beautiful place. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Did you get a picture?
Yeah.
Continuing on with item 7, an ordinance of the Township Council of the Township of Toms River, Ocean County, New Jersey, amending and supplementing section 348-9.32 of the Township Code to revise the regulations governing wireless communication facilities and public rights of way. This is a first reading.
Move the ordinance on first.
Second.
Motion was made by Councilwoman Urich, second by Councilman Kopp. Councilwoman Urich.
Yes.
Councilman Kopp.
Yes.
Councilman Lotano.
Yes.
Councilman Roderick.
Yes.
Councilman Turnbach.
Yes.
Council Vice President Maruca.
Yes.
Council President Gagan.
Yes.
Item 8 is a resolution of the Township Council of the Township of Toms River, Ocean County, New Jersey, urging the immediate repeal of Senate Bill Number 3454, Public Law 2021, Chapter 25.
Move the resolution.
Second.
Motion was made by Council Vice President Maruka, seconded by Councilwoman Yurick. Council Vice President Maruka.
I spoke in length today with our chief of police on this, and he is totally against this bill. He said what it's going to do is basically really handcuff our officers when they're dealing with any juvenile or any minor, and if it's with drug or alcohol involved there. So I will be voting yes on this resolution.
Councilwoman Yurick.
Yes.
Councilman Kopp.
Yes.
Councilman Lotano.
Yes.
Councilman Roderick.
Yes.
Councilman Turnbach.
I've also read the bill and support a yes vote on this. I think the Senate and the Assembly in revisiting this first have to immediately look at the parent notification for any juvenile that's charged with underage possession of marijuana or alcohol. This was a bill that was designed to legalize marijuana. Somehow alcohol got tied into this bill, and it's no longer unlawful for a minor to possess alcohol. So I think the Senate Assembly have to take a strong look at what they're attempting to legalize and why alcohol is being included in this. I've spoken to Senator Bhopal. I know he's got a bill that he's looking to present with regard to parent notification to get that addressed immediately. I think we've got to look further at this bill with regard to how it impacts the police and their ability to do what they're meant to do and to serve our residents. So I'll vote yes.
And Council President Gagan.
Yes.
Item 9 is a resolution of the Township Council of the Township of Toms River, Ocean County, New Jersey, urging the New Jersey Board of Public Utilities to take corrective action and order a reduction in service charges for Optimum Altice USA cable services due to inadequate and substandard service.
Move the resolution.
Second.
Motion was made by Council Vice President Maruka, seconded by Councilman Lotano. Council Vice President Maruka.
This resolution addresses Altice or Optimum, which basically in Toms River services the Barrier Island. I've had numerous complaints from residents from both the Ortley Beach section and also the Northern Beaches in regard to service, in regard to pricing. And I know last Tuesday, the 16th, the BPU held a hearing where municipalities and also the public was able to speak on this. And I know there was representatives, the mayor, the administrator, and representatives from our township on that. And we strongly urge them to open an investigation into this. And this resolution really supports that. So I vote yes.
Councilman Lotano.
Yes.
Councilwoman Yurick.
Yes.
Councilman Kopp.
Yes.
Councilman Roderick.
Yes.
Councilman Turnbach.
Yes.
Council President Gagan.
Yes.
Next portion of the agenda is our consent agenda. All matters listed under item consent agenda will be enacted by one motion in the form listed below. There will be no separate discussion of these items. If discussion is desired on any item, that item will be considered separately.
Do any members of the council have any item they wish to have pulled to discuss or vote separately?
Council President, if we could, item E, that would be
E as in Edward?
Yes, if Mr. Chinkalian could just come up and give us a little basic on that.
Okay. Any other member of the council wish anything to be discussed or voted on separately?
T and U, I'd like a roll call.
T and U?
T and U.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear. U is in Union?
Yeah.
That's the only one?
T and U.
T and U. Sorry. Does any member of the public wish any item to be discussed separately? Mr. Anderson? CC, okay, you and CC, okay.
Council President?
Yes, sir.
As there are a number of people requesting discussion on T and U, maybe we could have Mr. Roberts explain what T and U are and what it means.
Absolutely.
Yep. In addition, Council President, I'd like a roll call on V. I'm trying to find it. My computer's frozen.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you. It was all mumbles.
I'd like a roll call on V as well. My computer is frozen.
Sorry. V as in Victor?
V as in Victor.
Okay. For items T as in Tom and U as in Union, do you want to have them come up now?
Why don't we just move the balance of the consent agenda.
Okay.
Second.
Motion to move the balance of the consent agenda with the exception of items E, T, U, V, and CC. Motion made by Council Vice President Maruca, seconded by Councilman Letano. Council Vice President Maruca.
Yes.
Councilman Letano.
Yes.
Councilwoman Urick.
Yes.
Councilman Kopp.
Yes.
Councilman Roderick.
Yes.
Councilman Turnbach.
Yes.
Council President Gagan.
Yes. Go down this alphabetically. Item E is in Edward. We'll have Mr. Chinkalian come up and discuss that, please.
Good evening, everybody. This is our annual paving program. The contractor that we're awarding tonight, or hopefully you're going to award tonight, is P&A Construction. They've actually done, I believe, two projects with us in the past. Last year was Earl, but I know they had the one prior to that. They've done very good work. We expect to start, they've expect to start rather shortly. As soon as it's awarded, they'll post bonds. And as usual, we're going to, as you most likely know, our bid is based on a unit price at the time we award. That price varies month to month based on fuel prices posted, published by the New Jersey Department of Transportation. If prices go down, we get more paving. If prices go up, unfortunately, we don't. Unfortunately, this year, I think we all know what the price of fuel, I don't know if we're gonna get as far as we hope to. At the time of the estimate, we figured between 12 to 13 miles, but we're optimistic we'll pave until we exhaust the contract.
And Mr. Tinkalian, I know you have a map of the township and with the sections that will be going in chronological order where they will at least be starting.
Yes.
We do this every year, and this is part of our annual capital project where we do approximately $3 to $4 million for roads repavement every year, correct?
That's correct.
Okay. Thank Any you. Other questions? Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Move by to me.
Second.
Motion was made by Councilwoman Urick, seconded by Councilman Kopp. Councilwoman Urick?
Yes.
Councilman Kopp?
Yes.
Councilman Lotano?
Yes.
Councilman Roderick?
Yes.
Councilman Turnbach?
Yes.
Council Vice President Maruca?
Yes.
Council President Gagan?
Yes. Okay, moving on to item T, as in Tom and U as in Union. I'll ask Mr. Roberts to come on up. You can explain this.
Good evening, everyone. Yes, these two items are agreements prepared by our Special Counsel for Redevelopment, McMenamin Scotland Bauman, having to do with both redevelopment projects. One of them would be what we call the Lower Iron Street site, which is behind the former site of the Red Carpet Inn. They're parking lots that are owned by the township that the developer needs access to in order to be able to do due diligence in terms of the amount of analysis that's needed to prepare concept plans and et cetera. They need to be able to have that legal right. Same thing for the what we call the Robbins Parkway designated, Robbins Parkway redevelopment area, which is block 668, lots 13 and 9. Lot 9 is the township parking lot that's right down at the foot of Robbins Parkway. Again, concept plans that are being prepared for them as the designated redeveloper, conditionally designated redeveloper of both of those sites. They need to be able to have the ability to perform diagnostic studies of those parking lots, probably in most cases test borings. The agreements will govern the extent to which they will be able to restore those parking lots so that they are able to be used by the public in the meantime. That's basically my understanding of both of those agreements.
Okay. And also, Mr. Roberts, while you're up, if you would discuss item CC, because it's similar
sure.
and kind of goes along with that, I should have.
It's related. In this case, the redeveloper designations, when we adopt both redevelopment plans, the downtown core redevelopment plan covers the Robbins Parkway redevelopment area, and the waterfront redevelopment plan covers the original waterfront redevelopment area, which basically runs from Main Street to the Parkway and from Water Street to the river. We had done an RFP. Capodagli Property Company responded to the RFP. They were conditionally designated as the redeveloper of both of these properties. The one that was that was a result of the RFP was the Lower Iron Street project. There was an Upper Iron Street lot and a Lower Iron Street lot, both parking lots owned by the township. They responded to that RFP. They were designated. Those designations run for six-month periods. We've been into this process now for a couple of years. So every 6 months, we have to extend the for another 6 months, and then they then make a deposit, and that's called an interim cost agreement. That pays all the township expenses for professional costs and so on while we're still negotiating. So that's basically CC.
Okay.
For Robbins Parkway.
Thank you.
Council President, I got a question for Mr. Roberts. So just to confirm on T and U, we're really, just so everybody understands, we're really giving this company access to do site boring, site testing to figure out what we can actually conceptually put there, correct?
Correct. Yes.
Okay, so there's nothing more than just really we're testing the soil to see, come up with a plan in a sense.
That's right. I mean, in both cases, we're talking about structured parking. And
yep.
that's a different type of building than has been on those properties in the past. In order for them to be able to determine whether it's even structurally, the soil has the structural bearing capacity for a structure of that size, they need to do that kind of testing.
I appreciate that.
I have a question as well. A structure of what size?
Well, they're looking at multi-level parking structures, which are concrete, poured concrete. So it's a...
Now, you had said that they want to develop a plan. So I guess my question is, were you and I presented a plan?
Can you speak into the mic? Because I can't hear you back here.
The previous council. Weren't we presented a plan? I know you and I took a ride up to Hackensack, right? And we looked at different buildings.
Yes.
Correct. We were presented with the development attorney present, with Mr. Capodagli present. We were presented a plan, were we not?
We were. We gave a tour. They gave us a tour of another project in another city.
But I mean here.
Here they submitted concept plans with their original proposal.
Okay.
We've been negotiating with them on those concept plans ever since.
Okay, and I'm going to also need a roll call on CC as well. Thank you, Mr. Roberts. I appreciate it.
Mr. Anderson, did you have any other questions? Okay, very good. All righty.
You want to do T?
We'll
U
do
and
each
CC
item
separately.
We can do item. Yeah, item V. Yeah, we'll get to that on that roll call. Right now, I'll take a motion to move item T as in Tom.
Move
take each
T.
one individually.
Second.
To move item T, motion made by Councilwoman Urich, seconded by Councilman Kopp. Councilwoman Urich?
Yes.
Councilman Kopp?
Yes.
Councilman Lotano?
Yes.
Councilman Roderick?
No.
Councilman Turnbach?
Yes.
Council Vice President Maruca?
Yes.
Council President Gagin?
Yes. I'll take now a motion to move item U as in Union.
Move item U.
Second.
Motion was made by Councilwoman Urich, seconded by Councilman Lotano. Councilwoman Urich?
Yes.
Councilman Lotano?
Yes.
Councilman Kopp?
Yes.
Councilman Roderick?
No.
Councilman Turnbach?
Yes.
Council Vice President Maruca?
Yes.
Council President Gagin?
Yes. Now I'll entertain a motion to move item CC. Charlie.
Move item CC.
Second.
A motion was made by Councilwoman Urich, seconded by Councilman Kopp. Councilwoman Urich?
Yes.
Councilman Kopp?
Yes.
Councilman Lotano?
Yes.
Councilman Roderick?
Just to explain my last three votes, the council was presented a plan with 500 apartments
at one site. A simple yes or no is the vote. Council comments come at the end.
You continue to do that. It's very childish.
No, you're challenging. Yes or no vote.
I didn't say challenging. I said it's childish. Can I please cast my vote?
Cast your vote.
Okay.
Your comments can wait till the end.
I'm about to. You do this on a regular basis. It's childish. It's unprofessional.
Yes, you are. Is it a yes or no vote?
Are you through yet? It's my turn to vote. We have Roberts here. You're not supposed to interrupt me while I'm talking. It's my turn in the role. I would appreciate it.
And this is time for a yes or no vote, Councilmember Roderick.
So residents do not want 500 apartments on one site. That's what we were presented. And 250 on the other. That is why I voted no to the previous two resolutions. And that is why I'm voting no to this one as well. So, no.
So no is fine enough. Continue on, Clerk. Thank you.
Councilman Turnbach.
This vote isn't about apartment units of 500 or 250. This vote about access to a site plan. And obviously, we're going to have discussions on that if there's a site plan. I think we have to be very cautious about discussions that we've had and that are in part of negotiations, and I'd ask our township attorney to speak to that, as I know we've handled presentations in executive session for that reason. So this isn't a vote for 250 units, not a vote for 500 units. We have the best professional in the state of New Jersey, and Dave Roberts, just explain to the public what this is. Please do not buy the smoke screen. I vote yes.
Council Vice President Maruca?
Yes.
Council President Gagin?
Yes. Now we'll accept a roll call vote on item V, as in Victor.
Move item V.
Second.
Item V was moved by Councilwoman Urich, seconded by Council Vice President Maruca. Councilwoman Urich?
Yes.
Council Vice President Maruca?
Yes.
Councilman Kopp?
Yes.
Councilman Lotano?
Yes.
Councilman Roderick?
I'd just like to point out that no one interrupted Terrence when he made comment, because it's inappropriate to do so when someone's casting a vote.
You had your chance to talk.
You're doing it again. I just want to point that out to the residents, at how childish your behavior is. So I vote no.
Councilman Turnbach?
Yes.
Council President Gagin?
Yes.
That concludes the consent agenda. We do not have any reports tonight, so we move on to the bills.
Move the bill list.
Second.
Motion made by Councilman Turnbach, seconded by Councilman Kopp. Councilman Turnbach?
Abstain from PO21-01037, payable to the magistrates. I'm a local attorney in town. I have conflict with the magistrates. Yes to the balance.
Councilman Kopp?
I abstain from the following. 21-00878, payable to Ona Little Associates. 21-01294, payable to Silver and First Aid, and 21-01259, payable to the Board of Fire Commissioners, District 2. Yes to the balance.
Councilman Lotano?
Yes, I have to abstain from PO21-00880, only line 23 as it pertains to Lotano Development. Yes to the balance.
Councilman Roderick?
Voting no to PO21-01033, payable to Dastan McGuffin, attorneys at law.
Councilwoman Urich?
Abstain from PO21-00272, 21-00883, 21-00884, and 21-00892, payable to Rutgers University. And abstain from PO21-00875, payable to Remington and Vernick Engineers. Yes to the balance.
Council Vice President Maruca?
Abstain to 21-01034, 21-01035, and 21-01036, all payable to NJMVC. 21-01037, payable Township Payroll, line number 90. Payable to NJMVC Lease Program. I have a conflict. And 21-01033, payable to Dasty McGuckin, attorneys at law. Yes to the balance.
Council President Gagin.
I abstain from two bills, 21-01259 to the Board of Fire Commissioners, and 21-01294 to Silverton First Aid. Yes to the remaining.
And next, we have elected officials' comments.
Councilman Roderick, go ahead.
I expected that.
You're welcome.
Oh, I didn't thank you, sir. Again, more childish behavior. You realize this is televised. I mean, you look like a little kid. It's really babyish. That's all I have to say. I mean, it's really very, very babyish that you continue to interrupt me when I'm speaking, that you make these ridiculous remarks. It's very unprofessional. You're supposed to be the council president. I don't know if you've watched meetings in the past, but they were never handled like that under anyone, ever. And I've been coming here for, I don't know, 7-8 years, even before I was elected. I've never seen that kind of behavior. It's very, very childish. And I would appreciate it if you treated the office more respectfully. Nothing further this evening.
Councilman Turnbach.
Thank you, Council President. I want to thank Rabbi Harari for his words tonight. Rabbi Harari is someone I always enjoy listening to, whether it's at the celebration of any of the Jewish holidays. He's someone I learn from, I learn about his faith, and he's someone that speaks to the entire community. And Rabbi Harari is a leader in his community and our community, because he didn't have the easiest of welcomes in this community. He persevered, he formed relationships, and he focused on education. And when you speak about educating our children, it means something to me. I've been to your home, I've met your children, you've met my children. It's important that we lead, and that we lead by example, and that we educate that all faiths are important, and they're equal, and that all residents of this town are welcome in our town. That's what makes Toms River beautiful. I'm saddened tonight to have to make the comments that I'm going to make, not about Rabbi Harari. Tonight, I'm going to denounce a Facebook post that was shared by the Toms River Regular Republican Club. And it relates to, it purports to relate to zoning. It's a picture of members of the Orthodox community with members of our elected officials. It's ignorant. It's not about zoning. There's an old quote in law school that they teach. It's from Justice Potter Stewart. Once famously stated, "I cannot define pornography, but I know it when I see it." This picture's not about zoning. It's trying to spotlight our Orthodox community. It's not making our Orthodox community feel welcome within this community. It's not something the Toms River Regular Republican Club should be sharing. We just settled a lawsuit with the Department of Justice with regard to our zoning. How ignorant. Put out a Facebook post that's meant to incite division, that's meant to incite fear, that's meant to make people that are our neighbors not feel welcome in this community. We have to have the courage to stand up to this ignorance. We have to have the courage to educate our families and our children. That's not right. That's what I'm doing with my family. I appreciate Rabbi Harari doing it. That's what you're doing with your family. Public needs to know and pay attention to what's going on in the state of New Jersey right now. I'm going to draw your attention to two different townships, Edison Township and Hoboken. They're under investigation right now, both townships, for racist flyers, political flyers that are going out. There are lawmakers right now calling for a grand jury to be assembled. Look into it. Why would we go there, township? And I'm not saying we're going to go there, because I understand it's one political group. I understand somebody realized it pretty quickly because they took it down, right? But we've got to be educated. There's an Office of Public Integrity and Accountability. It's an office of the State Attorney General's office. And right now, they're investigating Edison and they're investigating Hoboken for these political flyers. They should take a look at this. They should take a look at this, because it's got nothing to do with zoning. It's meant to divide this town, and I'm going to stand here every time I see it from here on out for as long as I'm here, and I'm going to point it out, because it's unacceptable. It's not right for our residents. I'm going to stand up for all of our residents. I'm going to have the courage to do it, and I'm going to ask the rest of this council to have the courage to do it, to denounce what they see. It's not a political party. It's not. It's about a neighbor. It's about making sure people feel welcome in this community. We did what was right. Don't let this community be divided.
Councilman Hurek.
On a much lighter note, as the spring starts to come upon us, we have a lot of stuff happening downtown. And just this past weekend, Exit 82 started performing in their regular performance space again. Of course, limited capacity, and everyone was using COVID-19 precautions, sitting separately, and masks, and the performers were all masked, but it was a start. It was a start to that recovery and that post-pandemic life that we are all aiming for, that we're all looking forward to. So soon we have the Downtown Night Out is going to be starting up in May, I believe. And we're going to be able to, you know, be outside, be together in a safer environment. Hopefully a lot of people will be vaccinated. The vaccination rates are really picking up. It's we're actually finding that a lot of people that we're seeking out where I work, we're seeking out people to be vaccinated, groups of people, and they're already vaccinated. So it's great news. We're really making a lot of progress. So the light at the end of the tunnel is coming. So, you know, just keep hopeful and keep using those precautions in the meanwhile so that we can get past this. And then just the beach sweeps for the spring are April 17th. So we only have a couple meetings before that. So make sure you look at Clean Ocean Action and sign up for that, because we need to get those beaches ready for the summertime. And that's all I have tonight. Oh, and actually, thank you for the words, Councilman Turnbach, because it's really important that, and what Rabbi Ghawari said, the point of the Education Day is to teach one another and to teach yourself kindness and compassion and to be a good person. And that's just really, what are we doing if that's not what we're doing? You know, what is life about except trying to be the best person you could possibly be and to do good in the world? So that's all.
Councilwoman Maruca.
Thank you, Council President. I spoke a little bit about the BPU hearing, and that's something that I know this council and this administration will continue to advocate for the residents that are on the Barrier Island that do use the Altice and the Optimum cable packages and things of that nature. And also we're looking into JCP&L outage that we had over on the beach at the end of January, where we had a power outage and there was damages onto a lot of few of the residents' homes. I want to say there's approximately 50 there. There's some issues with claims and this and that. And what we're hearing, it's because of tariffs and the way the law is written. Well, I think maybe we need to change the law so each individual event is looked at differently. And I'd ask this council if we could come up with a resolution in support of changing that law and get it up to our District 10 legislatures to see, so our residents won't have to go through this, because this is the second time in the past 3 or 4 years that we've had outages and claims were put in and then claims were denied. So that's something else I'd like to look at. And kind of like to piggyback on what Councilman Turnbach has said, we're heading into the Easter season, we're heading into the Passover season. People of different faiths celebrate their own faith. But I think it's incumbent upon everybody to understand and to be aware and to educate yourself, your family, and especially the children of all the different religious groups that have all the different nationalities, all different colors, races, and creeds. We're better than this, Tom's River. We deserve better. Our residents deserve better. But most of all, our children deserve better, because people are a product of their environment. And if our children see people being unwelcoming or even, you know, disrespecting other cultures, that sets the tone. We need to break that. We need, everyone is welcome. And we need to be able to teach our children and teach our community that Tom's River is a welcoming community. That's all I have, and I wish everyone a blessed Easter and a good Passover. That's all I have.
Thank you. President. Councilman Kopp.
Thank you, Council President. To piggyback a little bit on Council Turnback's post that he shared, you know, I think I speak on myself, Councilman Lentano, Councilman Gagan, and Councilwoman Maruca condemning that post. The Toms River Regular Republican Club was an organization that was filled with hate, lies, and history of corruption. Coming onto this council, ourselves being new to this, we saw that. That is why we ended up starting a new organization that is going to work for the people of Toms River. It's called the Republicans for Toms River. Not to make a political stance here, but that organization is going to work for the people. To talk a little bit and thank Mr. Dave Roberts, we recently went up to see a couple of sites with the Downtown Redevelopment Organization. I'm happy that they're going to be doing some site studies here to figure out what we can actually come up with, conceptually, and come up with a plan here. You know, obviously, it's campaign season again. It started, it looks like the middle of March, elections in November, but it seems like we started already. Hopefully, it doesn't turn into another Sibagagi site that turned into multi-story apartments there. Unfortunately, you know, now it's a solar site with a couple thousand modules. But like I said, you know, hopefully we have a good, honest campaign season and we get the residents the truth of what's happening. And, you know, we work for the people here in a bipartisan measure, and we're going to continue to do this. And that's all, Council President.
Thank you. Councilman Lentano.
Thank you, Councilman President. Thank you, Council President. As I look out here in front of the crowd, I realize that it's the same people that come every week, and I want to thank the people who are involved, whether it's here or watching. It's very important to the township to have a well-informed, public. They need to be involved and understand the issues that go on in the town. And for the people who pay attention, they know that we're up here doing the best we can, and we make the right decisions on behalf of our town. I just want to thank you all for being involved and encourage your friends and family to become more involved. It's very important. It's a well-informed public is very dangerous to deceitful people, and that's what we need. That's all I have tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Mayor Mohel.
Thank you, Council President. Couple of things. I talked with Bob today, and at the last meeting we went out to bid for the beach repair for the damage that was done to the dunes. Bob says he anticipates having a contract to be presented to the council next meeting. It's important that we move forward on this. We want to start work around the middle of April to repair the dunes so that they're ready for the Memorial Day season and the beginning of the summer season. We've applied for FEMA funding. The project worksheet has been approved by FEMA, so we're optimistic we're going to get some funding, federal funding, for that project. As you know, when we were at the last meeting, back in January, the Army Corps of Engineers said they wouldn't be coming back to this area until next year. They'll be addressing it more thoroughly next year. This project is to get us to where we can build the walkovers, repair the dunes so that it's ready for the season and ready for any future storms. Also want to thank the council tonight. They awarded the contract for repaving. As Bob said, a lot of it's contingent upon the oil prices, and we know they're headed up. We had anticipated to do between 12 and 14 miles, but whatever mileage we can get repaved, we will do that with the funds that you approved tonight. If you look at the map and at the last presentation with the budget, there was pointed out the areas where we're going to be repaving. They're pretty much throughout the township. Their roads are being paved in each ward, so it's not like we've highlighted one ward. We try to get the roads paved that are in most need and do it throughout the township in a fair and equitable way. So I want to thank the council for moving forward on that, and I want to thank Bob for working on this project. He jumped on it right away with the dune project and also with the road paving. It keeps a list of roads to be repaved, and when residents have a question, they forward it to him and he evaluates the road and it's added to the list on a priority basis. So I thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. As I sat here listening to council comments, I was debating if I was going to say anything or just no further comment. It's obvious by tonight that I'll probably be the target of fake news for the next 2 weeks till our next meeting. With that being said, you know, everyone up here spends an exorbitant amount of time putting forth an effort to make this a better community. We spend time volunteering in various areas, serving on local civic boards to make it a better community, putting our best foot forward. I've said it before, hours and hours are spent in various meetings, talk to others, department heads, and whatnot before we come to the public meeting. That way we conduct this meeting in a calm, professional way, the way the public expects from us. You, Councilman Roderick, have managed to turn this into a three-ring circus. You've been censored 3 times in your single term. You've been served with a civil suit on the dais from a woman that you harassed via social media and your numerous fake Facebook profiles. We've even had to stop council meetings due to your unreasonable outbursts. None of these have ever happened in the history of Toms River Township until now. So far this calendar year, there have been about 3 dozen police officers killed in the line of duty, the last one being in Colorado last night, less than 24 hours ago, as a result of a deranged individual that also killed several other citizens, fueled by hate. Elected officials should not be adding to this hate. It's improper. We should be the voices of reason and have a calming effect. Your actions are negligent, reckless, and are potentially putting our police officers in direct harm's way and other emergency responders that may have to respond to your lies. We have an obligation to treat all residents of this town fairly, unbiased, and within the parameters of the law. Not just the ones that voted for us, but all the residents. It doesn't matter if they've lived here their entire life, moved to Ortley Beach from Monmouth County, or moved to Holiday City or Greenbrier from Jersey City and their primary language is Spanish. We have to treat all residents the same. As a police officer, the only thing worse than dealing with a drunk to convince them that they were drunk is someone with mental health issues. Councilman Rotter, I suggest maybe you take the flyers that were left by our mental health professionals earlier today. Seeing that, or is there any comments from the public? Yes, sir. Step up to the mic, state your name and address for the record.
Sam Foster, 108 Chico Drive in Breck right now.
Thank you, Mr. Foster.
First, I want to comment about what you said, Mr. Jekin, about the problems going on with council meetings. I'm a resident of Brick. I've been going to council meetings in Brick for over 10 years. Just want to tell you, I've commented about this in the past. It's very bad when we have arguing going on within a council meeting among the politicians, and we had this going on in 2019, mostly with Councilman Jim Fosman, who was constantly arguing and with not only the mayor, Mayor Ducey, fellow council members, and citizens. It's not conductive to good relations between public and the council members and the government. I said this during a Brick council meeting. I says the primary reason is this is a local government meeting, like a council meeting and freeholder meeting, is one of the few ways that the public can directly interact with the government, and that should be what everybody should strive to do is to try and have a conductive environment like that, the give and take between citizens and public. And when we have arguing like this going on, it's just not very good. And I don't want to see things get out of hand in Toms River like they did with Brick. One, 2019, one council meeting, councilwoman threw a folder at Councilman Fosman, and it just became a circus, and we can't have that. And it really did. And I was assaulted during a council meeting 2 years back in 2018 by a former Brick police officer. And there was no control over the meeting. So I want to thank you and your predecessor, Councilwoman Maruca, for taking steps to try and get these meetings under control so that we don't have these things going on here. I don't want to take up too much, but I have a couple other comments. I wanted to thank the rabbi for his comments. They were very, very well thought out. And I wanted to say, I have a delivery driver for DoorDash, and whenever I drive along Route 9 in particular, I notice that there's a great amount of diversity, religious diversity here in town, and it's really a wonderful thing to see. We have synagogues. There's a Muslim place of worship, a Hindu, I don't know if it's Hindu, some Indian, and a Christian, Protestant and Catholic churches. So it's really a very nice, diverse town, and it's what the rabbi said is words that everybody, regardless of your religious affiliation or whether you practice religion at all, should take to heart. It really is, and I want to thank him for that. Like I said, I deliver all over Toms River, and it's really good to see that kind of diversity. I'm not trying to pick on other towns, you know. I don't know what the ethnic group is. You know, I know people in Brick that go to church in Tom's River and they're Christian, so, you know. And I do have a question for you, quick one. I was making a delivery a couple of days ago, actually it was yesterday, in Tom's River, and you're speaking about road improvements, and I think it was the mayor that mentioned that there's a something about this. I have a question. I don't know what this, what it is in Tom's River. I don't know if it's standard throughout the state of New Jersey, but when I pulled onto into a development, I forgot the name of it now, but there was a very, just as you turn into the development, there's very big potholes there. Now, again, I apologize, I don't have the street, but whose responsibility is it, once you turn into a development, is it the legal responsibility of that condo complex to pave, or is it, at what point is there a, between
like a,
the...
like a cutoff?
Yeah.
It all depends on who, if it's a condo development, private community, is it a township road, is it a county?
Yeah.
So you can forward any address to Mr. Amoruso, and he'll have our staff investigate it and try to get it corrected.
Yeah, because he was like, really, as soon as I mean, the main road is fine, but I'm going to boom, 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 and I said, there, I'm going to need a front end alignment now. So, but okay. I did want to point that out, because like I said about the religious diversity in town and the rabbi, no matter what religious beliefs, or if you even have any, his words were really something you can take to heart about being good in every person. And I'm disappointed that this box here didn't have cupcakes. I told you. I said that was, the woman was bringing cupcakes. I was going, oh, yeah. I was going to elbow you out of the way.
There you go.
Anyway, thank you.
Thank you for your time. Okay. Any other member of the public wish to be heard? Yes, sir. You in the black, sir. Please state your name and address for the record into the mic. And your address, please, for the record.
2015 Red Cedar Street.
Okay.
So I live on Red Cedar, which is the street directly behind the high school.
Mm-hmm.
So on Coolidge, going from Route 37 to Bay, from East Windsor where the light is, not East Windsor, I used to live in East, sorry, from Windsor where the light is, every street, seven of them, there's drains on both sides.
Mm-hmm.
The 8th Street, Red Cedar, no drain on the other side. The woods behind the school, you could drive by right now, put a little boat in there, float around in there, and that was from the water from a little while ago. Like, I understand where I live, below, you know, the water level, but, and Red Cedar has a big slope. Mm-hmm. And I understand that. I saw that when I moved in. But I didn't realize, you know, I didn't stand in the middle of my property and look to the street. If you look to the street, which is just one lot away, the lot next to me, they'll never be able to build on. I kind of like it because they'll never build on it, but it's because it's a swamp. Mm-hmm. There's no place for the water to go. So when it comes down the hill, the street's high. There's my house and there's the lot. So I'm like in the middle of a cut. I mean, I'm not a surveyor, I'm a teacher for the state, but you can just look out maybe 100 yards and you can see the level of the street is pretty high, so.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, I mean, that's not my surveying and all that, but I kind of feel like if there was a drain there, it would make a big difference. So I had a little issue with water and I called a plumber, and I just shot that out to him and he goes, a drain would definitely make a difference. And I just think it's strange that there's a drain on every street. I didn't count the ones that are from Windsor, because there's drains on most of them, too.
Mm-hmm.
But they're probably a little bit higher as you go down. There's more water, I understand that. So
right.
I just wanted to, I figured this was, is this the...
Absolutely. Coolidge Ave is a county road. I'm sure we can have Mr. Amoruso and
besides
Mr. Chinkalian reach
too.
Out.
I mean, that's another day for me to come and tell you about that, but I'm worried
sure.
about the water.
Right, right. Mr. Chinkalian's coming up now. Maybe he can shed some light onto... Mr. Chinkalian's our township engineer. Thank you.
Because I think there's been guys out there surveying, and like he just says he's taking measurements, but I explained to him, and he even said the street is, you can see where the street is. But sure, I'll email you.
Address and I'll look it up.
No problem.
Thank you for coming. Letting us know. Does any other member of the public wish to be heard? Mr. Raymond. State your name and address into the microphone for the record, please.
I can take the mask off.
Yes.
My name is Christopher Raymond. I live at 111 Flax Street, Toms River. I come before the council tonight and the mayor to ask for the township's permission to rename 54 Washington Street, which you probably all know has been loaned for a dollar to the schools forever. Mm-hmm. I don't know what forever means, but I'm told many years ago it was the original board office for the school board. I asked that it be named for Mr. Al Dietrich, who passed away approximately 6 weeks ago. Mr. Dietrich was the superintendent in the schools for 13 years. He was an educator for 29 years. I have the backing of the interim superintendent, Tom Gianello, on the board, but it's not their decision to make. It's up for the town to say, yes, this would be the appropriate name for Mr. Gianello. We originally asked for 1144 Hooper, but in speaking to the family, they felt it would be best served as to where Mr. Dietrich spent a lot of his time. And so I asked the mayor and council to consider this. It would mean a lot to the Dietrich family. Mr. Dietrich, if you knew anything about him, he really started this district back in the 1960s, continued as a superintendent. I have to believe there's some people probably in this room who benefited from him, whether it be in the classroom or raising children into our school. So I ask you to consider this, and I thank you very much. And I just did want to say something. I wasn't going to say anything, but something Mr. Turnbach brought up and a couple of you mentioned. I've lived in Toms River my whole entire life. My mother was born in Lakewood. She still lives in Lakewood. She was born at 6th Street, 636, and she's a practicing Jewish person. So I have to tell you, she's 79 years of age, and I can only tell you how many times I have to assure her that the people of Toms River are not what you read. So I'm a practicing Catholic, but my mom is my mother. So, you know, I take offense to what I see, what I read, and I think we're better than that. So I just piggyback on what Mr. Turnbach said and a couple of the others. But Toms River is better than what we are. So, but thank you for listening to me.
Thank you
very much. Appreciate it.
Okay. Yes, sir. The white shirt. You would name an address, please, for the record.
Boogie Kalashina, 2121 Discovery Way, Toms River. Dan, come on, man. I thought we're friends. We go out for drinks. Now we chill. And then you just put me on the front page of your thing just because it's an election year?
What front page that I put you on?
Rhetoric for council or something like that.
You're talking about the news article.
I'm talking about the news article, yes. And you made sure that my face was in there. You and your buddy at Shore Network News.
I made sure your face was on there?
Well, you definitely put
it's
it on there.
It's a strong accusation. So do you have any kind of evidence?
There's over 100,
I put you on there.
There's over 100 comments on there. And you keep on talking about voting Mo Hill out and getting all the council out.
I would like all of them.
I would appreciate it if you let me finish.
Go ahead.
Okay? About getting everybody else out over here, but you put a picture of me. We're friends.
I didn't put it.
We're friends.
First of
I'm
all,
the one. Listen to me. I put out a statement against that 2-acre ordinance. I put out a statement. You read it. You know I put it out, which means that this council over here was not with me. How dare you put me on your front page of your paper just for your election?
What ordinance?
You know what? Forget about you.
Yeah. What did you give me to read?
I'm sorry?
You just said you gave me something.
I put out a statement against the 2-acre ordinance.
When did you give that to me to read?
Listen, I know you read it. Did
no,
you
I
or didn't you read it?
And I don't own Shore News Network.
Did
and
you?
Yes, I shared the story because the story is true.
Good.
So, I would like to know what it is that you find to
know,
be so inappropriate
know.
About the story.
It's not appropriate about the story. It's appropriate
what was
that
inappropriate?
Me, that I'm on the front page of your thing. It's you should have told me.
It's not my
dude,
paper.
You're the one that put it on there.
It's, first of all,
Dan.
It's not my paper.
Dan.
You represent an organization.
Dan.
That organization lobbies.
Dan,
you're a public figure. Are you a public figure, sir?
Yes.
You're here, right?
Yes.
So you're a public figure?
Yes.
Okay, did you lobby this council for a change?
I'm sorry?
Did you lobby this council
I did.
For a change?
I did.
Okay, so then I would think Mr. Stilton's article, news article, is a fair article. And your picture, just as Mr. Turnbach's picture, whoever else's picture, if you're a public figure and you lobby and you come to council meetings to call councilmen out, you may wind up in the newspaper. In fact, Jean Mickle is over here right now and she's writing up a story. So I really don't understand what
Mr.
the point
Roger.
You're trying to make is.
Listen.
You lobby.
And we're friends. A public figure.
We're friends. Friends, before they do stuff, they talk to each other. I never posted anything about Dan Roderick or against them.
I shared a news story.
Dan, you haven't...
I shared a news story.
Dan?
Tell me what about that story that
Dan?
I shared was false.
Dan, listen to me.
What about that story was false, sir?
You let me finish? Can you please let me finish? You have my cell phone number. I'm waiting for your phone call. You're going to call me, and you're going to apologize. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Okay, is there any other member from the public that wishes to be... Come on up. Please state your name and address into the mic for the record, please.
Hi, how are you? Jennifer Howe, 22 Admiral Avenue. I'm coming tonight. I'm a school board member in Thames River. And I just wanted to invite the council. Not all of you don't have to come because won't be enough room. But on March 31st at 6 p.m. at High School South, it'll probably be in the cafeteria, which is the entrance off of Hooper Avenue. Mm-hmm. We have our citizen advisory meeting for our budget. We were cut... every year we do get our state cuts, and then we go over our budget, and I think it would be good to see what is in jeopardy for the students and what the town, we have a lot of shared services with you. Thank you for everything you do for our schools. You do save us so much money, but if there's any small things in our budget that we see, we would like to just have you come out and hear what the citizens have to say, the parents, what their worries are about the schools. Right now, I know that Trenton is going to give us some sort of aid. I know that they're hearing us. They're working with us in a very polite manner, which is fantastic. But it's just something that I feel like our school and our council, we're such a tight community, and our districts are, we employ a big percent of the town, and it would be an honor for us to have the mayor or any council members show up at the meeting. It's not too long. It's a lot of numbers. It does get a little confusing, but it's a great meeting to come to. And another thing is, since people are watching, and if anything gets in the paper, we are in desperate need of bus drivers for the schools right now. We are about 30 short, so we are trying to get these kids back to school more, but we have such a need for bus drivers. Full-time substitutes start at $20 an hour. I know that our unemployment rate is up in New Jersey, so if you can spread the word, we are really in need of bus drivers because our buses, we're trying to social distance. We just had to have one of the elementary schools closed because there was an outbreak on a bus. They had to quarantine the bus, which leads to, okay, your sister's here, your brother's there, then you have to, follow the tracing. So if anyone would like to please share that, we are in need of bus drivers. And lastly, I'm also the vice president of the Thames River Education Foundation. And right now, it's difficult to have events because of COVID. We know we wanted to do fire pits and food trucks, and there's all these rules with outside occupancy. So we're just asking to for local business owners out there, if you want to get your name out there, we'd love to shout your name from the rooftops that you donated to our foundation. We're going to have some fundraisers soon. We're looking to do a golf outing in the summer. So on behalf of the students of Thames River, again, this goes right to extracurricular activities and sports. We've already given $15,000 in a short time to the schools. They really appreciate it. The coaches are like, we need a jersey so bad. I think I wore that jersey when I was on the football team, and it's still circulating on the team. So we appreciate our businesses in the area. And when people hear, this place donated, people will go there. So I just would like to put the word out there that we are looking for donations. So thank you so much. Have a fantastic holiday season and have a good night. And thank you for everything that you do. We appreciate it.
Thank you very much. Is there any other member from the public that wishes to be heard? Mr. Anderson, come on up. Just step up to the mic, name and address for the record, please.
A lot going on.
Yes,
Art Anderson, 12 Park Street, Thames River, New Jersey. I lived downtown for 25 years. I love it here. But I can tell you in the past, and even now in the future, we've had problems with apartments, hotels, and motels. Actually, I was here in the beginning of the problem that we had with Red Roof Inn. So that's why I'm a little concerned that now, I love that the Americana closed down, but now I see that the next planning board meeting, they're looking to put up 79 hotels, rooms now instead of 29. And we had problems with them in the past. I know the planning board does a great job, and there's some variances they need, but I know, like Terrence, you were saying about almost a year ago that maybe we need to put security cameras in some of these buildings and areas. So I don't know if there's something we could do with the code enforcement or the town that when they build these or whatever, that we do put, I know there's privacy issues, but just security cameras on these properties because of the issues we've had in the past? That's
okay.
It. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you very much for your comments. Is there any other member of the public that wishes to be heard? Yes, sir. Name and address, please, for the record.
Thank you. My name is Tom Smith. I'm a Jackson resident, 520 Whitesville Road. The reason I'm down here is for Toms River Block 2, lots 3081 and 3085. It's the old Sam and Paul, the front address is 534 Whitesville Road in Jackson. The rear lots of that property are Toms River. For years now, they've been filling the wetland transition, clearing in the back. There's no pinelands. Permits, it's in the pinelands. There's no, I've done open requests, there's been no applications completed with Toms River Township for all this clearing facility. It's turned into a truck terminal. I've spoken to Mr. Mackel and zoning many times, they issued violations. Toms River Municipal Court has been adjourned for upwards of 3 years on this. I was down here a couple of months ago about it. Monday, March 15th, we reported 10 triaxle loads of material dumped in the back of this property, commercial trucks. I don't know if it's road millings. I kind of doubt that it's virgin stone being dumped back there. Mm-hmm. And then this afternoon, we watched in the truck terminal area, a diesel mechanic, they had a diesel spill. We watched them scrambling around to clean it up. And you know, we record this. It's right out of our window. We mm-hmm. live right next door to it. We invested in that property because it's pinelands. Protected with wetlands around it, so we had the opportunity to get that property, we did. Now we have this neighbor who has been filling for years. They don't seem to have a care in the world about any violations issued because it keeps getting continued. Mm-hmm. I brought the 10 triaxle loads to Mr. Mackel's attention on Monday. I got to thank you for your observations. We'll try to get someone over there to look at it. Mm-hmm. Several phone messages and emails since, I have not got courtesy of a response. Even find out if anybody even went out to look at what's going on out there. So I'd really appreciate it. If somebody can get back to me, I'll leave my comment.
Sure. I'll ask you to write your name and phone number down to give to our administrator. I'm going to ask Mr. Chinkalian, who's coming up here. He's a township engineer, to maybe try to answer some of the questions.
Council President, this is a difficult case. We have been, I believe Mr. Mackel has already issued violations. It is the court in the court. I've personally been on a call with Mr. Mackel to the Jackson zoning officer. We've made them aware that they have to get a site plan. This is a commercial property, but I will follow up with Bernie to see where it stands with the court. Zoning Officer Mackel, I believe, has issued summons on this property. But you know, as you know, once we apply to the court, we have to follow the
right
that they're scheduled, but okay. I will follow up.
Oh, okay, thank you very much. Thank you, sir. Does any other member of the public wish to be heard? Okay, seeing none, I'll close public comment.
Motion.
Take a motion.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And I take a motion to go into executive session.
Executive session.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Whereas Section 8 of the Open Public Meetings Act, Chapter 231, Public Law 1975, permits the exclusion of the public from a meeting in certain circumstances to discuss matters requiring confidentiality and or of a privileged nature, and whereas the Township Council is of the opinion that such circumstances presently exist. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Township Council of the Township of Toms River in the County of Ocean and State of New Jersey as follows. The Township Council will now conduct a private executive session. The general nature of the subject matter to be discussed and or acted upon is as follows. Matters of personnel, attorney-client privilege, and contract negotiations. The following specific items to be discussed and or acted upon are as follows. Executive session minutes review of February 9, 2021, personnel issues of the Township Clerk's Office and Administration, and the renewal of the New Jersey Natural Gas franchise. It is anticipated that the deliberations conducted in closed session may be disclosed to the public upon the determination of the Township Council that the public interest will no longer be served by such confidentiality. Motion to go into executive session made by Councilwoman Urich, seconded by Councilman Turnbach at 7:10 p.m. With all in favor. Oh, thank you so much. What you said was perfect.
I could not have a school system, but what you're doing is.
Oh, thank you.
Blessing. All right, I'm coming. Well, I'm coming.
Thank you so much. I'm not going to finish. I want to, but I won't.
Thank you.
cigarette.
Do I have a motion to go back into public session?
So moved.
All in favor?
Aye.
Do I have a motion to adopt the resolution to approve the executive session minutes of February 9th, 2021?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Motion to adjourn?
I have to abstain.
No.
I was absent.
Councilman Robert abstains. And the motion to adjourn, I'm sorry?
Motion to adjourn.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
At 7:27 p.m. Thank you, everyone.